we have come a long way from shortage to surplus. So obviously, the scenario has changed. The narrative also has changed. That time we were trying to find out ways and means how to increase production. So today, our rice production has crossed 115 million tons, wheat production 102 million tons, horticulture 315 million tons, and the kind of growth that we have seen in terms of production, and this growth, if you compare global level, it's a tremendous growth. The growth in fishery sector, the animal husbandry, particularly milk sector, more than 6% growth. So this is a remarkable progress that we have made in the field of agriculture. But more than that, which is essential in this context, is we have to give more emphasis to the growth and story and then diversification. See, we have done pretty well in food grains, but we don't require so much of food grains now. And keeping in view our demand supply, future demand supply, and even international markets, we have to now go for planning appropriately for crops. Diversify to horticulture, where we can have processing value addition and export. But that is the area which we have to focus. Also, at the same time, the paradigm has to now shift that it's not just enhancing production and processing and market linkage, but also adequately addressing the farmer's income. Water, for instance, you know, it's a serious constraint in today's world. Now, when water is a constraint, we can't indiscriminately grow rice beyond what we need and beyond even what we can trade in the international market. So that is and that's what we are doing, preparing a plan, crop plan, of course, including rice. And this crop plan is not just based on agroecology. It will also take into account the current demand supply situation domestically, what is existing, and also global today and the forecast for another 10 years. So that we have a proper plan, and it will take several months to actually, we have already started working on this. So this plan would guide us that whether we should grow upland rice, 4 million hectares of upland rice, should it be really continued, or this land should be diverted to horticulture. Similarly, areas where there is water is a serious constraint, should we be growing rice? In Punjab, for instance, how much of underground water keep lifting and where the power is free? Or should we have some measures to control use of water? In case of rice wheat system, in Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh, you have largely rice wheat system. You have rice potato system, you have also sugarcane coming in. So this need to be really modified with new technology. For instance, I said in case of rice, you can go for direct seeded rice, you can go for aerobic rice, you can go for short duration rice where water saving can happen. You should go for, in case of crops like sugarcane, a drip irrigation system, fertigation associated, where you can save water as well as chemical fertilizer. And this we have standardized in many. And in case of rice, we have standardized, also we are standardizing another technology called subsurface drip irrigation system in case of rice. So you have developed models of 151 climate resilient villages. And these models now globally recognized. World Bank has also recognized. And these models are being replicated in Maharashtra, for instance, with World Bank support. And 5,000 villages are, being made climate resilient through huge amount of funding. Similarly, other states are coming forward. The Telangana, the Odisha, other states are coming forward expressing interest that they would like to also replicate these models there. What are the components there? Component is the climate resilient crops and varieties, first of all. And diversified systems, like animal system, small ruminant system, diversified system of operation. And similarly, availability of seeds, the fodder, because if they are not available, these systems will not work. And institutions that you build, risk management committees, in the villages, so that they are there local level, they are able to address these changes situation, scenario. We are also going to sign MOU with MSME, department of government, so that, you know, this mechanization is also facilitated. So we are going to sign, so that the manufacturing of these happens by the small manufacturers in local areas, so that they are readily available, because that is a main issue. So there will be training taking place. They have centers, and there the manufacturing can take place. That will be supported. They will provide funding support also for this small enterprises, medium enterprises. So there will be kind of these supports, and we have this MOU, and this will facilitate it. So all this. We have also created incubation centers in our institutes. We have about 25 incubation centers, and we are incubating entrepreneurs, because these small and marginal farmers to be supported, and their produce to be taken, aggregated and taken to the processing, so that they have more returns. So they are promoted, and so they are encouraged, and youth also comes in the process. So youth, local youth is also attracted towards agriculture. So entrepreneurship development through various schemes we have now in our own program. So 104 agri startups we have established, and now we are going to increase to at least 300 in coming 5 years. So at least 3 times to 5 times increase as our target. So in UP, to start with, we chose 8 villages, and we worked with DCM Sriram, and 4 sugar mills were roped in to help us, because that was the sugar belt. So it's a beautiful example of public-private partnership. And in those 8 villages, we surveyed, we prepared all the documents and baselines and all that, and started working on those, providing technology support and all other associated kind of requirements, and then try to measure what we are did the progress. And what we find after 2 years, now it is 2 years, that it has gone up to 1.8 times.
Okay.
This is the model that we have built. Besides this, we have chosen 2 villages per district, and the KVKs are there in every district.
Yeah.
So they have taken up these 2 villages. So they are demonstrating how we can double the income of the farmers, so that everybody is convinced that what Honorable Prime Minister said is feasible, it can be done, and it requires concerted effort. Total subsidy system that we have is a huge amount, several lakh crores we are spending on that. And at the same time, the market and production, there is a kind of mismatch, because production is more, the marketing is not happening as much, so there is a gap. So I think we have to now rethink the whole process, and also in that subsidy system, direct benefit going to the farmers and going elsewhere. So there is a whole lot of issues there. So we need to really address that adequately. We can have saving from there, and that saving can go to the post production, kind of issues to be addressed adequately. Appropriate routing of the subsidy and adequate investment, both public and private, happening in this sector. Export being doubled, agri export being doubled at least in 5 years, with all these technology innovations and processes to be in place for that, and in the process bringing that much needed change. And certainly there will be many policy dimensions which need to be addressed.